Our family recently became first-time chicken owners, which meant we needed a coop. We built our dream coop on a budget, and we will show you our three favorite add-ons. We started out super budget-friendly by finding this playhouse off of Facebook Marketplace for $60 that needed a little bit of help. We started by securing the existing shingles, replacing old pieces of wood, making a floor out of plywood, and just basically enclosing everything. There's lots of different ways to protect your coop, but we raised the whole coop off the ground by adding 4x4 pieces of wood that we had on hand to help with any erosion or water issues. When it came to the overall design of our chicken coop, we revolved it around our large pecan tree. Some of the reasons are to protect from predators, which we have hawks mostly, and hot summers, so this would provide shade. We made a hexagon shape, which is 6 sides, and one of the sides is the chicken coop, so really, only 5 sides are made out of the 2x4 wood frame. We used one of the window openings on the playhouse for our nesting boxes. We used 2x4s and built outwards so there would be more room on the outside instead of trying to have the nesting boxes on the inside of the coop. We have 8 chickens and 4 nesting boxes, but they really only use 2 of them. The chicks started getting big and started escaping their brooder and getting all over my kitchen, so we finished enclosing the coop itself and got them moved out there while we could finish working on the run and getting that enclosed.
A couple things we need to fix, like some of the vertical 2x4s aren't vertical, they're like slanted, so but we'll fix that.
Lots of chicken wire was used for this project, and one of the biggest debates is hardware cloth versus chicken wire. Hardware cloth is definitely the better material and way more sturdy against predators, but our predators are hawks and cats, so we went ahead with the chicken wire since the hardware cloth was quite a bit more expensive for the amount that we're using. So that's something we can always eventually upgrade, but obviously it's ideal to do the first time around. Definitely learned how the best way to tighten the chicken wire was with a screwdriver and pulling it tight. We ended up designing what I describe as a collar of 6 small 2x4 pieces that are all attached together and then screwed into the tree with 1 screw and creates a very sturdy support for those other 2x4s without causing damage to the tree. As in Dallin, are making our permanent chicken feeders and waterers. So I wanted to show you what this is looking like. This is our waterer. It's basically done. We just need to attach these drinking cups at the end, but this whole thing will be full of water. We are going to have, the reason why we put this piece on the tops of all of them is so that we can fill it up with water from the outside of the chicken coop. We won't have to go inside the chicken coop. This whole thing, both of these are going to be full of feed. We have 2 waters and 2 feeds. We go out of town sometimes and we just didn't want to have to worry about, you know, having anyone have to come over and take care of the chickens. So we're trying to be as self-sufficient as possible. Something I wanted to point out is that these caps do not fit on the 4-inch PVC pipe. So what Dallin did is he cut these individual pieces to go inside, and that's what's happening here. Anyways, I'm gonna try to make a diagram explaining all the pieces that you would need to build something like this. These are pretty tall. The ones that I saw online were kind of actually cut probably to half this size, but I wanted them to be tall so that we could hold as much food and as much water as possible. They're kind of ugly, but they work.
Is that exciting?
Wow.
Is that the whole bag?
Yeah. Okay, can you show trying to put the lid on this? Really? So they have figured out the feed, but they're all on that one. Adding all the chicken wire to the top half of the coop was definitely tricky, but we wanted to do it especially before our tree was finished blooming, and now that the leaves are all nice and full, it adds another layer of protection from predators. Our coop is finished, and there's always things we can add on to it. We're actually wanting to get some ducks in the spring, so we might need to add a few more things for them, but we love how it turned out. Our three favorite features are these feeders and waterers that are super tall. We've received a lot of compliments on them. Less maintenance that we have to do. We added in this automatic door later that we are so happy about. We don't have to go out and put them back in or let them out in the morning, which was a huge game changer. And our final favorite feature is actually this swing. The chickens truly love it, and so do our kids. Thank you so much for watching. Please drop any questions you have below. We'd be more than happy to answer, and follow along for more.